Right now we are suffering a crisis in terms of academic science, that about 80% of the biomedical papers that are published can't be replicated. This is a disaster for the world of science, which relies on that. On the other hand, what we are seeing from biotechs, companies that are actually trying to make money and get patents, is much better research. You, Mike, Dr. West, have the patents on everything from the creation of embryonic stem cells to telomerase to the treatment of various diseases, and now we're finally seeing those come to fruition in the remarkable spinal cord injury trials, where we're seeing so far 6 young men who would have been on their backs, unable to take care of themselves, feeding themselves, texting, lifting weights, driving, even going forward with marriages. And I think within the next few months we're going to see similar evidence from CellCure, your subsidiary in the area of blindness. So this area of stem cell medicine is obviously incredibly powerful. Could we leap forward? What are you working on now? That's 20-year-old technology. What have you been doing for the last 2 decades?
Well, first, about your contrast with academic medical research and that done in the biotech setting. In the past, I've heard biotech research called, biotech science, as though it weren't quite to the standard of academic science. I would disagree with that assessment for the reasons you pointed out. In academia, there's an urgent need to publish science papers, regardless of necessarily their accuracy or reproducibility, because that's what fuels grants and the labs in academia. And I don't mean that as a shot at academia. Academic medical research has done an enormous and amazing amount to lift our understanding of everything from cancer to aging. But in biotechnology, there's no motivation to publish papers. In fact, some biotech companies never do. The interest is in translating basic science into actual therapies that can be approved by the FDA, and typically blinded trials. So, neither the physician nor the patient may know what's in that syringe that's being injected into their heart or wherever in the body. And so it really has to be real. It has to be real science. And so there's less of a motivation to, fudge the numbers or whatever, as you sometimes see in academia.
And you may not want to give away your project to the competition.
Yeah, well, that's sometimes the case. That's sometimes why biotech doesn't publish papers, for instance. In regard to the future, regenerative medicine, as we call it today, is far more powerful, I think, than almost anyone realizes. We literally have the ability today to manufacture any of the cellular building blocks that make up the human body. And of course, we're a multicellular organism. Our bodies are trillions of cells glued together, and the cells are alive. They're living organisms. And so there's liver cells, there's heart muscle cells, there's skin cells, there's brain cells, hundreds of different kinds of cells in the body. In aging, some of these become dysfunctional or die, and you have chronic degenerative disease. And the body cannot replace them, and so you're stuck. For instance, heart failure. You lose heart muscle, and you get some drugs that can make your heart beat stronger, but eventually you die. It's a death sentence currently. You can hope for a heart transplant, but that's a difficult procedure. It's expensive. You have to find a donor, etc. Now, regenerative medicine allows us to manufacture all of the cells of the human body on an industrial scale for millions of people. And all the cells are young cells. It's an amazing technology platform. It is rolling out as we speak. So we have clinical trials underway for spinal cord injury, for blindness, and hopefully soon additional applications where we apply this technology to the heart or other Right. places in the body. The most imaginative breakthrough that I've ever seen in my lifetime, we call induced tissue regeneration. It's really built on the prior revolutions in biomedical research. that we've been involved with, telomeres, pluripotent stem cells, but it takes it to a different level. The concept of induced tissue regeneration is that we'll be able to provide patients with a therapeutic regimen that will unlock the body's ability to spontaneously repair and regrow the tissue in the human body, like some of these animals can do. You know, there are salamanders, you cut their leg off and the whole leg will regrow. That doesn't happen in humans. It may surprise you that we think that that's possible to make ITR actually happen. But I would just simply point to the fact that early in human development, we have that ability. It just lost once the human body is completely developed.
Obviously, those developmental genes are still in the genome.
Yes.
It's right. Just a question of activating them right. And allowing them yeah. to do that yeah. remarkable repair and rejuvenation.
Yeah. So I would say this about the future of medicine and biotech. Some of the best science has historically been done in biotech. You know, PCR, which is so widely used when we watch forensic TV late at night, came out of biotechnology. Some of the best science comes out of biotech, and it will in the future, and some of it will have an unanticipated power to alleviate not only human suffering, but the costs of healthcare as America ages, as the baby boom generation plays out in the United States and indeed around the world. So I've never been more optimistic about the ability to grow industry, to build jobs, to advance science than I am right now in the year 2017.
To be clear, I think it's important that we realize this is not simply about repairing a missing arm or a bad heart, but we're talking about taking somebody who is quite aged and repairing the whole body, in a sense, making them younger.
Yeah, I would never have thought, I knew that we could reverse the aging of human cells. We could even immortalize human cells. That may surprise people, but that's actually some number of years ago already. But the idea that tissues in the human body could actually be turned back in time, that you could reverse age-related changes in the body, surprised me. But it's clear that we're going to be able to do that in the coming years.
Fabulous. Fantastic. Thank you, Mark.
Thank you.